شكرا يا ربي شكرا هديت قلبي شكرا نورت دربي شكرا شكرا يا رب.
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. الحمد لله. It's really an honor to stand in front of dignitaries and such amazing audience. Yes, indeed, it is Allah's help which I am able to talk here. Today, my talk is about success. How do you define success and how does Allah define success? Let us just take an example to understand it better. If I was going with a bunch of a young men and women and drove by beautiful mansion. Just a gorgeous house on the top of the hill. And other side, there is ocean. And on the into the house, there is a gorgeous car parked outside. And back of the house, there is an incredible backyard and swimming pool. Whatever you can imagine is there. And see that guy walking into his home. When he asks this man and woman, do you think this guy is successful? These people will say, yes, he's pretty successful. When somebody gets a job, buys a home, start business and owns a new car, we consider these things as success. And according to dictionary, success is also defined as the fact of getting, achieving wealth, respect or fame. So the bus keeps driving and we saw the man, he's homeless on the street. And he was like, he was wearing the clothes from couple of months. When I asked the same question, do you think this guy is successful? What will they say? They will say, no, he's not successful. That's the problem. The problem is the way we think about success and the way we think about failure. What a beautiful understanding of success that Islam teaches us. That isn't when one accumulates wealth, power, or fame. Genuine success and paradise when one purifies their heart and soul. Subhanallah. When you start thinking about the Book of Allah, you'll realize the most captivating, magnificent homes that was ever lived was a castle of Firon. Now tell me, is he successful? No, he was the worst loser in all the human history. And now let's talk about Prophet Ibrahim alayhis salam. He was told to leave his home. He was homeless, but he was successful. He was one of the most successful men that was ever lived. Now we can know what Islam teaches us, that success has nothing to do with wealth and failure has nothing to do with poverty. And Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, peace be upon him, said, worship Allah if you see him. Indeed, you cannot see him, but Allah sees you. It is the life of taqwa, of keeping ever present in your conscience, that lead to success. Open your hearts, ears, and to listen and take guidance when Mu'adhin calls out you 5 times a day for salam. Thus come towards success. Thus, success is an eternal quality which cannot be attained only in dunya but has to do with life hereafter. With these few words, I want to conclude my speech. Jazakallah.